Hello everyone. Welcome to this Bold Reports tutorial. In this video, I will show you how to integrate the Report Viewer control with an Angular 16 application. Whether you are just starting with Angular or looking to enhance your app with reporting features, this step-by-step guide will cover everything from setup and configuration to utilizing Report Viewer features for an engaging and user-friendly reporting experience. If you are looking to enhance your Angular 16 application with advanced reporting, integrating the Bold Reports Report Viewer control is an excellent choice. This tool allows for the seamless display of interactive, detailed reports, offering rich data visualizations and a user-friendly experience. It features advanced charting and drill-down capabilities, and supports exporting to PDF, Excel, Word, and CSV formats. The Report Viewer ensures secure data handling and provides a responsive design for all devices, simplifying report management and presentation. Before integrating the Report Viewer control into your application, ensure that your development environment includes the following. Let me show you how to integrate the Report Viewer control into an Angular application using Visual Studio Code. Before creating the new Angular application, I need to install the Angular CLI globally on my machine. The Angular CLI is a command line interface tool that helps developers create, manage, and maintain Angular applications. I open a command prompt and run the command to install it. Then, I create a new Angular application and name it Angular Report Viewer. The ng-new command prompts you to provide information about the features to include in the initial app project. I would like to add routing to the Angular application, so I press Y and then Enter. I accept the default CSS stylesheet format by pressing Enter. Next, I configure the Bold Report Viewer component in the Angular CLI application. I change the directory to the application's root folder to install two npm packages. First, I install the Bold Reports Angular library in the application by running this command. It provides Angular components for reporting functionalities within your application. Then, to install the Bold Reports types package in the application, I run this command. This package provides TypeScript type definitions for the Bold Reports library. I open the created application in Visual Studio Code, which I am using for editing purposes. You can use any editor to get started. Next, I need to configure the types for the entire application. So, I open the tsconfig.app.json file and register at types and at boldreports/types under type roots. Additionally, I add jQuery and reports.all under types. The Report Viewer requires a window jQuery object to render the component. Since I'm using Angular 16, I create a global.ts file within the src folder and import jQuery. I also create a window instance to ensure that the jQuery library is globally available in the browser environment. If you're using an Angular version prior to 12, you should add this code to the src/polyfills.ts file. Next, open the angular.json file. Copy the Report Viewer component style from the documentation and add it to the Styles section under Angular Report Viewer, which is the name of the application. I use the Tailwind Light theme, but you can modify the theme based on your application's needs. I need to initialize the Report Viewer component in the application. So, I open the app.module.ts file. Import the globals and Bold Report Viewer module from Angular Reporting Components. Next, I add the Report Viewer scripts and import the Bold Report Viewer module within the ng-module class. Now, I need to invoke the Report Viewer component on the client side to view the report. I open the app.component.html file Add the Bold Report Viewer tag to it after removing the existing code. This is a custom HTML element provided by the Bold Reports library, which is used to render reports within a web application. Inside the tag, I need to add the ID attributes, report service URL, report path API properties, and styles. The ID attribute specifies the unique name for the HTML element, so I assign the value report viewer control. The report service URL specifies the URL of the report service that processes and renders the report. And the report path specifies the path to the report that you want to render. The style attribute is used to add inline styles to the Bold Report Viewer element. Next, I open the app.component.ts file and set the report service URL and report path property within the app component class. In this demo, the ASP.NET Core Web API service is hosted on my local machine. So, I add the report service URL and report path properties and their values within the constructor. The report service URL set with localhost indicates that the service is running locally on the same machine as the application. While the API/report viewer path specifies the API endpoint for the report viewer service. Now, everything is ready to preview the report. I run the ng-serve command. The URL has been generated. So I copy the URL and load it in the browser. As you can see, the sales order details report has been rendered in the Angular application using the report viewer control. In this video, I have shown you how to integrate the report viewer control in an Angular application. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.